Each religion has its own story or stories of how that religion came to be and how the universe was created. These stories differ from religion to religion, yet there seem to be many similarities between them. More specifically, Hinduism, Jewish, and the Chinese religion share some likenesses in their creation stories, yet the individuality in each religion's creation stories can be identified.
The Hindus have several creation myths to examine. The first, which seems to be one of the more popular myths, starts out with a large ocean that covered the whole world. In the ocean was the snake Ananta, who was guarding Lord Vishnu. From Vishnu's navel grows a lotus flower. Out of this flower comes Lord Brahma. After a while, Brahma becomes lonely and because of this creates the living. He divides himself in two, becoming man and woman. Some believe he creates other living things in this way, while others think animals formed from different parts of his body. Gods that make up what the Hindus believe to be the Supreme One. Lord Brahma, known as the Creator, makes the universe. Lord Vishnu, the Preserver, keeps or preserves the universe. And Lord Shiva, the Destroyer or Recreator, destroys the universe, which leads to the making of a new universe. First, Lord Vishnu is found in the water. Next, Lord Brahma creates the universe. And then, after some unknown amount of time, Lord Shiva destroys the universe. After that, the only thing left is the ocean that covers the world, where Lord Vishnu can be found. The cycle starts over again, the universe being created and destroyed again and again. This cycle is why the Hindus have a strong belief in reincarnation or rebirth. Brahma creates the universe from himself and he is part of the Supreme One. Therefore, the Hindus see everything as part of the Supreme One. Living things are looked at highly and many people are even vegetarians. When the universe is created and destroyed, this is when reincarnation takes place. The Hindus' belief in karma plays a large role in reincarnation. If there is good karma, a tie to what is done in the current life, then when reincarnation takes place, a person will be better off in the next life.
Another Hindu creation story is of one that takes place through four eras. The first era, lasting 100,000 years, was known as the Satya era. During this time, Vishnu created 10 avatars, an incarnation of a god. The first of these a fish, second a tortoise, and third a boar. The last avatar was half man and half lion. There was also a bull named Dharma that was made. Dharma means what people are born to do, and the bull stands for morality. In the Satya era, the bull stands on 4 feet. During the second era, or Treta era, Vishnu creates more avatars. The dwarf, Rama, and the king of Ayodhya. Dharma the bull is now standing on 3 legs. Thirdly came the Dwapara era. This time period is represented by the bull standing on 2 feet. This era ends when Krishna returns to Vaikuntha, his home. The fourth era, Kali era, is what Hindus believe us to be currently living in. This era starts with the death of Krishna. Dharma now stands on only 1 leg, which the Hindus believe represents how people's spirituality is degenerating. A third creation story of Hinduism starts out with a golden womb. The womb was the only thing there, just floating out in the darkness. This womb broke into 2 parts, one called heaven and the other earth. The sun, which was contained in the golden womb, was what created all things of the universe. Once the golden womb broke open, the sun created energy and heat. These lead to atoms and molecules being formed, and eventually the whole universe came into being. 14 worlds were formed, 7 heavens and 7 hells. Another creation story of Hinduism is of wind and fire. Brahma was known as the greatest creator, yet Agni, god of fire, and Vayu, god of wind, spoke of how great they each were. When Agni and Vayu heard that Brahma was said to be the greatest, they went to him to see how great he really was. When Brahma had heard others claiming to be better than him, he was ready to prove them wrong. Agni approached Brahma, and Brahma gave him a task to prove himself. Brahma placed a straw in front of Agni and told him to burn it because he was claiming he could burn the whole world. Agni tried his hardest to burn the straw, but just couldn't do it. Next, Vayu came to Brahma, claiming he could blow the whole earth away. Brahma placed a straw in front of him, saying if Vayu was the greatest, he could blow away the straw. Vayu was not able to blow the straw away, though. Then Indra came to Brahma to see how great he was, but Brahma was not there. Instead, a goddess was in Brahma's place. She was there to inform Indra that only Brahma could control the fire, wind, and other greatnesses because he and he alone created them.
Continuing with the Hindu creation stories is one about a man named Purusha. This particular myth about the formation of all the things of the universe is a Rig Vedic hymn. The Rig Veda is one of the four components of the Veda, the Hindu holy book that is written in Sanskrit. Purusha has 1,000 heads and 1,000 eyes and 1,000 feet. This man Purusha is everything in the universe. He occupies and makes up everything. One quarter of him is creatures, and the other three quarters of him is everything that makes up the heavens. Even though Purusha is called man, he is an immortal. A god named Burj forms from Purusha. The gods need to make a sacrifice, so they use Purusha. This sacrifice is not one that we normally think of, however. This sacrifice takes Purusha and breaks him up into many different parts to form all the different things that make up the universe. For the sacrifice, the gods use spring as the pure butter, summer as the igniter, and autumn as the offering. From the man Purusha, many people of the universe were formed. From Purusha's mouth, Brahman was formed. Also from his mouth, the god of fire, Agni, and the supreme god, Indra, was created. From Purusha's breath, the god of wind, Vayu, was also created. From Purusha's arms, the nobles were created, and from his two thighs, the rest of the population came into being. From Purusha's feet, the servants came. Also from Purusha, many objects were created. From Purusha's mind, the moon was formed, and from one of his eyes came the sun. Purusha's navel became the atmosphere of the world, and his head became the heavens above. Also from Purusha's feet, the earth was formed, and from his ear, the sky came into being. After the sacrifice had taken place, the pure butter was used to create the animals of the earth. The animals of the air, of the forest, and of the cities came from this pure butter. Some of other animals that formed also were the horses, cows, goats, and sheep of the world. From the sacrifice, verses, chants, meters, and formulas came into being. The universe was now created, and there were seven worlds that made it up. Not only the Hindu religion, but the Chinese religion has many creation stories as well. A widely accepted creation story for the Chinese religion is about Pan Gu. The universe, something like a black egg, contained Pan Gu as he slept for 18,000 years. After that time period, Pan Gu took an axe and broke his way out of the egg. As the egg cracked open, the clear substance inside rose up to create the heavens, and the remaining part of the egg became the earth. Pan Gu was now trapped, standing between the heavens and the earth. Then the heavens and the earth grew 10 feet each day for 18,000 more years, Pan Gu growing 10 feet each day as they did. After 18,000 years of growing, Pan Gu was still between the heavens and the earth so that they would always be separated. Then Pan Gu died, and his breath formed the wind and clouds, and his voice became thunder. One of Pan Gu's eyes became the sun, and the other one the moon. Parts of his body formed five mountains, and his blood turned to water, forming oceans and rivers. From Pan Gu's veins, roads formed, and from his muscles, land formed. Pan Gu's hair turned into the stars in the sky, and his skin became the flowers and trees. Jade and pearls were created from Pan Gu's bone marrow, and rain came as Pan Gu's sweat. When Pan Gu is happy, the sun is out, but if he's angry, dark clouds appear in the sky. The fleas and lice from Pan Gu are the ancestors of humans. There is also another story of Pan Gu. God of the heaven, King Gao Xin, owned a dog named Pan Gu. King Gao Xin and King Fang were enemies, and King Gao Xin stated that his daughter would marry who brought him King Fang's head. King Gao Xin's offer was just brushed off, however, because everyone knew King Fang had strong soldiers. Pan Gu heard King Gao Jin's offer and ran away from him when he was asleep. Pan Gu ran to King Fang, who welcomed the cute dog with open arms. During the night, Pan Gu bit off King Fang's head and ran back to King Gao Jin with it. King Gao Jin was very pleased and had meat brought to Pan Gu. The dog, however, refused to eat the meat and went to a corner to sleep, not eating or moving for the next 3 days. King Gao Jin didn't understand Pan Gu's behavior and asked the dog if it was because he couldn't have a dog marry his daughter.
Then Pan Gu miraculously spoke. The dog told King Gao Jin that he should place a golden bell over him, and after 7 days and seven nights, Pan Gu would be a man. King Gao Jin did as he was told and placed Pan Gu under a golden bell. On the sixth day, the princess was scared that Pan Gu would starve, so she lifted up the bell. Pan Gu had already started the transformation into a man, but it was not yet complete. Pan Gu had a man's body but a dog's head. In spite of the unfinished transformation, Pan Gu and the princess married. Although the princess did not want to be seen with Pan Gu, they lived in the mountains of southern China. They had 3 boys and 1 girl, and they were the ancestors of humans.
A third Chinese creation myth is about creating people again after a disaster. A flood had wiped out everyone except a brother and a sister who survived by using a large gourd as a boat. When the flood was over, the brother wished his sister to be his wife. The sister, however, refused. The brother persisted, so the sister told him that each should take a stone, go to adjacent hills, and roll the stones down the hill. If the 2 stones were to be found in the valley below with 1 stone on top of the other, then they shall marry. The brother accepted her proposal, though found it very unlikely that the 2 stones would land upon each other. The brother went to the valley and placed the stones one on top of the other. When they each rolled the stones down the hill, they went into some tall grasses, so the brother called to his sister to show her the stones he had put there. The sister did not fall for this, though, and proposed another test. She said they would each take a knife, stand on opposite hills, throw them into the valley, and if both knives were found in the sheath placed in the valley, they would marry. The brother secretly placed both knives in the sheath in the valley, and when they threw the knives, the sister had no rebuttal, so they wed. Together they had 1 child, but it was born without arms and legs. The brother was so enraged that he took his child and cut it to pieces. He then scattered the pieces throughout the hillside, and when he returned there the next day, the pieces had turned into men and women. Yet another Chinese creation myth has no creator at all. Spontaneously, vapor comes from binary forces fighting each other. The upper and lower spheres, yin and yang, bring about changes that start the universe. The heavens and celestial bodies form, and then the sun, moon, and stars come into being. The heavens contain 9 layers, and the celestial bodies having 9 celestial gates being held up by 8 pillars standing on earth. Jewish creation story starts out with God creating the heavens and the earth. God created light next. He saw that the light was good and so separated the light from the dark, forming day and night. The first day came, bringing with it morning and evening because of the lightness and darkness that was created. God then divided the waters. Now the second day came. Land was created and earth appeared. Plants and trees were then able to grow on earth. The third day arrived. A big light and a small light were created to control the days and nights from heaven. On the fourth day, God created animals to live in the waters and birds to live in the skies. On the fourth day, God created many different creatures to occupy the earth. On the sixth day, man was created. God took dust and created Adam to look over all the creatures of the universe. God put Adam to sleep and used one of Adam's ribs to create Eve. God then put Adam and Eve in a place called paradise.